Started 7 years ago. I was on radio. I was working at WestJet, of all things, as a guest service agent. And I got a phone call from a man named Steve Olson and said, would you like to come to SAIT and teach? And I went, well, I don't know if I can teach. I mean, a radio guy, but he wants to have somebody succeed him and take over. And I said, well, I'll do my best. And that was the ushering in. And I was on a contract for about 4 months when I first came to SAIT. And they said, would you like to try this? After the four-month trial, by December, they said, yeah, we're going to keep you. And that's where it began. So about 7 years ago.
I've only worked with Beesley in my capacity as academic chair of the RTBM program for 2 years, I would say. What I like about Beesley is that he's very committed to the success of our students. And he's always looking for ways to work with learners to make sure that they are growing, they are learning, they are pushing themselves.
Will pay!
Instead of being the guy that's on the air with a few friends listening here and there, to see if people can actually get it. And when I say that, the light goes off and I go, you got it. And it's the most rewarding thing. When you talk about SAIT and why we came here, I think that's what it is. It's getting to know you. If that's a good thing, I think that's what SAIT is. Do I do everything by the book? My family always says, Dad, you bend the rules. Yeah, I will follow rules, but I think that's just one of those things that I've always done. And can I break some of the traditional roles of a teacher to make you understand? Yeah, I'll go out of my way to make sure that happens.
Oh, I think he's the greatest, you know? He's just your, you know, your typical teacher. You know, he knows what he's doing. That's the most important thing. But, you know, 10 out of 10 guy.
Instructor by day, crusader by night. He puts a cape on and he goes and does the Flames games. And I get an opportunity to call out the greatest hockey players, in my opinion, in the world.
I think the unique impact that Beesley has on his students is the fact that he is currently active in industry. He's the voice of the Flames.
The Flames was gave me a gift, which is to amplify what I do. And do I have a passion for hockey? Yeah. Equal to radio? I would say so. That's where it probably started as a kid playing Pup, Adam. Then we went to Bantam, on to college before it all ended with a check from behind on my neck. That was pretty much it for my hockey career. Amongst all of this, there was a man by the name of Russ Peak, and he was the CFCN CTV sports anchor. For 13 years, he was the voice of the Calgary Flames. And he said, Beesley, my wife says I should get out of the business. How about you take over the reign? And I went to an audition, and it's about 20 people in the media lounge downstairs. And it was quite funny because they said, pick one name and announce that name in the Saddle Dome. Okay, the Saddle Dome's completely empty with the exception of this lounge of these 20 people trying to get this job. And I took the microphone, scored by, and I said, okay, yeah, let's do this. Flames goal scored by number 14, Theron Fleury. Three claps in the Saddle Dome. And I went, well, probably didn't get the job. Walked away from that. About a week later, I got a phone call. You're in the running for the Flames job. And I went, what do you mean, in the running? Well, there's you and this other guy named Paul. Paul Boucher, dear friend of mine from radio days. And he was going to go one night, I would go one night. And then we'd go back and forth before they'd eventually say, you're in. And it was at that point that Paul said, I'm out. And I went, that means I got the gig? Phoned my dad. I said, Dad, you know we always wanted to make it to the big leagues. And it's emotional for me to tell you the story because when I was on the phone, I said, here's the deal. I'm going to be at the game. So if you turn up CBC tonight, I'm there, I'm at the show. And he didn't quite understand what I was talking about. And yet, right up until the day he died, Hockey Night in Canada, if Flames were playing, he could reach over the TV and crank it. My sister said his ears bled just to hear his son's voice. I guess my point is there's two sides to Beesley, which is instructor, and then at night, let's go Flames, and loud, and yeah, excited, passion. I think if you ever look at anything that I do here at SAIT and then at the Dome,
yes,
it's equal. It's the same word. It's passion over and over.
Beesley's a great instructor. I love working with Beesley, and I hope that Beesley will continue to be a part of the RTBM program for many, many years to come.
Journey 103, Break My Stride. That is Matthew Wilder. My name is Beesley, and if I leave you with one message, I think this one harkens back to when I was just a baby, this tall. And I listened to this band, obviously influenced me big time. Wouldn't it be nice? The Beach Boys are on Journey 103.